to go faster, simplify, then add lightness. While Colin Chapman's still quoted adage defined the early years of Lotus, his fellow garagista Bruce McLaren took a subtly different tack as his fledging team came to dominate Can-Am racing in the late 1960s with a succession of increasingly brawny Chevrolet V8-powered monsters. Add lightness, then add more power. Bruce and Colin are no longer with us, but their philosophies still guide the companies they founded. And the McLaren 720S is the best demonstration yet of McLaren's core principle of peace through superior firepower. With 710 horsepower, its twin-turbo 4.0-liter V8 is 49 horses up on the Ferrari 488 GTB, a car that's rarely accused of sluggish road manners. At the same time, the McLaren's power-to-weight ratio advantage has been sharpened further with an even more carbon-intensive architecture. The new Monocoque 2-tub now incorporates carbon fiber consisting of the windshield surround and continues through the center roof section. These improve structural integrity. Load-bearing for the 650S, this car's predecessor, was handled entirely by the lower tub, which explains why coupe and spider versions had the same torsional rigidity. The composite greenhouse components also save weight compared to the previous model's aluminum pillars and windshield header. McLaren says the body is 40 pounds lighter, with the 720S's overall dry weight falling to a claimed 2,828 pounds with every available lightweight option. To go faster, simplify, then add lightness. While Colin Chapman's still quoted adage defined the early years of Lotus, his fellow garagista Bruce McLaren took a subtly different tack as his fledging team came to dominate Can-Am racing in the late 1960s with a succession of increasingly brawny Chevrolet V8-powered monsters. Add lightness, then add more power. Bruce and Colin are no longer with us, but their philosophies still guide the companies they founded. And the McLaren 720S is the best demonstration yet of McLaren's core principle of peace through superior firepower. With 710 horsepower, its twin-turbo 4.0-liter V8 is 49 horses up on the Ferrari 488 GTB, a car that's rarely accused of sluggish road manners. At the same time, the McLaren's power-to-weight ratio advantage has been sharpened further with an even more carbon-intensive architecture. View 26 photos. The new Monocoque 2-tub now incorporates carbon fiber consisting of the windshield surround and continues through the center roof section. These improve structural integrity. Load-bearing for the 650S, this car's predecessor, was handled entirely by the lower tub, which explains why coupe and spider versions had the same torsional rigidity. The composite greenhouse components also save weight compared to the previous model's aluminum pillars and windshield header. McLaren says the body is 40 pounds lighter, with the 720S's overall dry weight falling to a claimed 2,828 pounds with every available lightweight option. The same but very different. So, while the fundamentals of a carbon body and a mid-mounted V8 sending torque to the rear wheels remain the same, pretty much every detail has been tweaked or changed. Visually, the most obvious difference is the loss of the 650S's side air intakes, with the 720S looking sleeker and more muscular without them. Air is now directed to the engine and radiators by a well-disguised channel next to the rear windows. While our praise for the design at the rear is unalloyed, the back bears a distinct resemblance to the McLaren P1 with the rear wing.
Thanks for watching and subscribe.